Here we have three scientists, an archaeologist, a terrestrial ecologist, and a marine ecologist. They are on a quest to understand the present by reconstructing the past. However, their venture is very difficult because the past is past. It is gone, and we have no such thing as time travel. But this doesn't mean that our scientists are getting discouraged. They are resourceful folks with a few tricks up their sleeve. Take the archaeologist. To understand ancient human civilizations, the archaeologist goes on the hunt for human bones and relics. A bit like Indiana Jones, but without guns and whips. Now take the terrestrial ecologist. To understand the history of forests, she looks at the growth rings of trees. As trees grow, they form new layers of wood that can be seen as annual rings. These can be used to figure out how old a certain tree is. But it is not just information about the age of trees, because plenty of other things like bushfires and droughts leave marks in the rings which can be reconstructed. However, when it comes to the marine ecologist, what tools do we have to reconstruct the past? Fish don't grow in rings. If we cut up a fish, all we get is sashimi. For this reason, the marine ecologist had to come up with an even more ingenious idea. Upon careful inspection of the body of fish, the marine ecologist discovered that even fish grow in rings. Well, not quite in the same way. It is their ear bones that grow in rings. You may not have seen a fish ear bone because they are quite small and fragile. However, when you put fish ear bones in the hands of a marine ecologist, a whole wealth of information can be revealed. First, you need to know that each species of fish has ear bones shaped in a unique way. So ear bones can be used to identify species. You can use this information to determine what fish, birds, or seals, for example, have been eating. But this is just scratching the surface. Because by using some high-tech instruments like lasers and even synchrotrons, yeah, I said synchrotrons, marine ecologists can almost travel in time. Trace elements and stable isotopes can be measured and used to answer some very important ecological questions. For example, fish ear bones can help us understand the structure of fish populations, their migrations, and even characteristics of the environment, where they lived, and how that has changed. Isn't this incredible? All this from a teeny tiny ear bone that you probably didn't even know existed. Do you want to make your own amazing discoveries in marine ecology? Visit the Gillanders Aquatic Ecology Lab website for more information about our research and opportunities to study with us. We've got lasers!